Thank you all very much. My name is Milos. I just saw me on the video. So basically, I came here to tell you a little bit more about how we are looking at creating smart cities and helping this reshape this urban spaces that all of us share, and how we actually came from a small startup in Serbia 7 years ago to the company where we are now present in over 30 cities in 20 countries around the world. So first, before we start, just to make kind of for us to be on the same page, how many of you actually used a phone booth to make a phone call in the last, let's say, 10 years? Nobody. Yes, exactly. The world is changing. Technology is changing the way how we live, how we communicate, how we interact with other people. So our needs as people are constantly changing, and our cities remain pretty much the same as they were 100 years ago. And we wanted to change that. In the same time, cities are struggling with these new technologies and new needs in a way that they need to better understand what's happening in a city. They need to better understand all of this urban data that's happening. What's the air quality in the city? What's the air quality in the city? How many people are moving? In what time? And we wanted to help cities as well reinvent and bring these all of our public services and public spaces into the 21st century. In the same time, while this technology is changing the way we live, for example, it's impossible to even imagine the world without a smartphone today. Everybody has at least one smartphone. So our needs as people constantly are evolving in a way that it's, you cannot live without access to internet, you cannot live without your powered-up phone. And in the same time, companies and big brands are struggling to get attention of us as consumers. So we actually came up with a very innovative model to actually help to reinvent and improve our cities without spending taxpayers' money, which is essential in this new phase where we are going, where cities are around the world, running low on the budgets, and they still constantly need to improve. And we came up with a model that will help cities improve our public spaces without spending taxpayers' money, and actually having the companies on the other end invest into some kind of a new advertising platform, let's say, that will help not just promote themselves as a good company and responsible players in the market, but also will help improve the quality of local communities. And that's why we invented the Smart Bench. Super easy to install, completely solar-powered piece of street furniture, the bench, that brings a lot of these services to public spaces so that you don't have to worry about all of these basic services that you are in town. Are you going to run out of battery on your smartwatch, on your headphone? Are you going to run out of data on your cell phone, or the signal is bad, so you cannot call a cab and stuff like that? And at the same time, we wanted to make it very interesting for brands so that they actually attract their attention as well, so that they invest into this infrastructure and they finance it in this kind of a unique, innovative public-private partnership where the companies are actually financing the way that we improve our public spaces. And that's what we did. We launched this smart city infrastructure as a service model, where we chose London as the best place to start. London is a very old city, very traditional, very hard on a bureaucracy, and we thought, if we succeed in London, we'll make it anywhere. And we started off rolling out a network of smart benches in London, where we are providing benches completely free of charge to the city. And this was the original case when we launched. We partnered with big brand, we partnered with Ford, and we also partnered with a local charity. Because this is not just the way how we look at the smart cities and these innovative business models. It's not just about advertising. We wanted to do something good for the community as well. So we partnered at the same time with cancer research as well to help them raise more money to fight, of course, this horrible disease. So that we added contactless payment feature to the bench, so people are able to just tap on the bench to donate, in this particular case, £2 to cancer research, in the same time, while promoting this good cause, also provide people free services. And we launched with that model. This is basically just to showcase the reception of the scheme. The bench was used by hundreds and thousands of people on a monthly basis. We started with just 10. We are now at 40 locations in central London, and we're growing to 100 by this summer. And we are now starting to expand this to other cities in the world as well. In the same time, of course, we will not be able to cover all of the cities around the world, and we want to help as many as a company. We want to help as many cities improve their public spaces as possible. So we are also selling dimensions. So any city, any company, any university campus and shopping center around the world can just buy the bench and install it on their own, which will be like an old way of doing things, and we want to also offer that. But most importantly, it's not just about the benches. Yes, the bench is the most important piece of street furniture in a way that it's been around for 1,000 years. It will be around for additional 1,000 years. But our cities are full of this obsolete infrastructure that we want to change. Things like bus shelters, payphones, streetlights, all of them didn't change at all or didn't change much for the last 50 years. And we are now working on multiple projects to actually bring these smart services to this infrastructure to improve accessibility, safety, air quality, and other basically modern technologies bring to our cities. That will be all. I don't know how much time do we have left, and do we actually have time for any questions? 3 minutes left. So if anybody has any questions, I'll be happy to answer to use the 3 minutes. Otherwise,